Hi there. Today we are looking at this nice box from Creality. So let's get started. So first of all, let's open the box. The second part is the bottom of the printer. Mostly assembled and nicely wrapped in foam. To keep everything in place, there's some plastic between the axis and the actual printer frame. You won't see it on camera, but at the mounting points there's already a tiny bit of damage on the frame. It's probably because it was tested in the factory. The glass plate is nicely packed with foam, and it has some nice rounded corners. It looks like the bed is not completely flat, but that should not be a problem because that's printing on the glass and not on the actual bed. Unless on some older models, it seems there is a bit of strain relief on the heated bed connector. This is not 3D printed, but actually injected molded, and looks pretty stable. So, let's put this away and move to the next part. First things first is the accessory box. Then we have the power supply and control box. And a roll of tape, which is actually a pretty big roll. Personally, I don't like using tape for printers, but we'll see. I probably will try printing on the glass first. And the last part is the Z-axis. So let's get trying it out. There's a tiny bit of filament already looking left at the printer head, so it's probably tested in the factory before it's shipped. Now, let's have a look at what's within the accessory box. First, some tie wraps and other tools used to assemble the printer. Then we have the installation instructions. A sharpened blade, be very careful with this, it's very dangerous, so be sure to use it safely. Personally, I don't like to use it, so I just put it away. Here are all the screws needed to assemble the printer itself. And, of course, the spool holder. Then you have a plug. They sent for a chance, a European one. USB cable. It is actually mini USB, which is pretty uncommon for these kind of printers. And a few spare parts. Looks like a nozzle, a bowden tube, and a few screws. It's actually nicely included. A small bag of PLA, I guess around 0.5 kilo. It can be more, but I guess it's enough. A small tool to clean the nozzle, which is really sharp, but nicely protected for. And a micro USB card with reader. And I guess a spare bowden tube, as the bowden tube itself is already connected to the printer. So that's the accessory box. There's a nice sticker here with quality check passed, but no idea if this actually anyone having looked at it. I don't think so. Of course, always remove the plastic from your LCD. Now, let's get started with the assembly. So, first things first, they explain a bit what you need to do or what is included and what you actually need. Then they are explaining that you need to compare all parts within the box to the actual parts you were included within the box. And then they say that you need to connect the M5 screws to the base. So let's do that. So the first thing you need to do is connect the base with a M5 by 25mm screw, and that's probably going to into this bottom of the printer, and it's screwed within the base frame. So let's do that. Before we actually do this, we need to remove a bit of plastic here. I guess it's because to protect the printer or the motor from shipping damage. And there also seems to be a tire up here, so let's get a side cutter. And a side cutter is actually included within the tools, so let's use that. Now let's mount the frame. Before we do, let's get the correct hex wrench, which again is nicely included within the package. I'm going to remove the glass plate to make sure it's not damaged when doing this. So that's all done. Another thing I noticed is that one of the screws here got loose, I guess during shipping, so let's mount that again. Another problem is that the lead screw is not mounted to the actual coupling, so we need to fix that as well. And there is some dust on the lead screw, so let's remove that, probably from the packaging. So, looking as both of the thumb screws were actually not mounted at all, it's probably left like that in the factory for shipping damages. Everything seems really sturdy, so probably no loose screws. The frame itself is also really sturdy, only the table is actually moving and it's not the printer itself, so it's really nice. So let's continue with construction. Now we need to mount these T-slots, so let's mount them to the printer frame. These parts are actually made from metal and not plastic, so really sturdy. You need to position the T-slot nuts so they can actually fit within the frame. After that, you just need to tighten them and they should move to the side to lock in. You should make sure they do that, otherwise they won't have any use at all. For example, this one didn't move correctly, so I unscrew it and after that I try again, and this time it did move and now it's set correctly. Of course, with the last one you can't see it at all, so you just need to hope it actually moves in. Now, the second one. This actually has a bit of plastic, acrylic, that holds the end stop. The T-slot part itself is made from metal again. So, let's move it to its position at the other side of the printer. So, that's most of the mechanics done. Now, let's move to the next part. I guess I need to mount this tool holder, but it's not mentioned at all. Ah, here's a second part of the instructions that tells you the lead screws are indeed not locked. So you need to do that yourself. It's not mentioning the spool holder at all. So I guess it's just two screws into there. So you have two thumb screws, so I guess let's use that. So that's the spool holder done. Now let's connect everything to the printer. First off, let's move it a bit up to the side so we have more space here. The heated bed and the extruder have really nice cables, so they are really easy to connect. And because there's a small indentation, you cannot connect them wrong anyway. So let's connect them to the control box over here. So that's done. Now let's connect the building tube to the extruder itself. It's simply pressing the tube inside of the coupler. Lastly, we need a few connectors here. They are all labeled, so that's very easy to connect. So let's start with the extruder body and the x-axis. So this is the x-axis motor, and the connector goes somewhere around there, so let's move it up a bit. So they only can be mounted one way, so there's no need to look to or there's no problem connecting them incorrectly. So that are the extruder motor and the x-axis. Now need to connect the x-axis end stop, which is behind the motor. And it's a pretty tight fit, so be careful when doing this. There we go. Now let's do the I-axis motor. Again, these connectors can be mounted only one way. And lastly, the Z-axis, with the Z-axis end stop. I'm actually going to undo the T-slot because it's not able to fit there. It's a really nice space there. They should mention this within the instructions. So that's a lot easier. So that's everything connected. Now time to power it on. So there we go. You probably won't see it on the video, but it's powering on the screen. And it's telling it's a CR10. And it's currently 19 degrees over here, which probably is right. It's pretty cold. Now, let's see if we can do a auto hum. This one is working. That one as well. Now, let's see if the set is working. You might not hear it, but there's a pretty loud fan within the control box. And also the hot end fan. So, there we go. Because the glass plate isn't on there, it's not close enough, but we will do that soon. So, let's level it and finish it off. So, first of all, let's mount our glass plate on the frame. These binder clips should hold it in place pretty well. Now, there's a bit of filament left on the printer head itself, so let's remove that before we are actually going to calibrate it. So, there we go. Now, let's move everything to its home position again. And disable the steppers. Now we can start calibrating the axis. So I already noticed here it's way too high. And here it was better. I think that was one of the loose screws, so that's probably the reasoning. Because the rest of it is pretty close, so let's just fix that one first over there. Now we will use a piece of paper between the nozzle so we can test it. As you can see, I can't fit it at all, so it's way too high. So it is getting there, but it's a bit too loose. Nearly perfect, so let's continue with the rest. This actually is pretty thick paper, so it probably needs to be a bit lower, but we will see that I'm doing this third sprint later today. Because we modified all other corners, this one is wrong again, so we need to be modifying it a tiny bit. So, that seems to be perfect now. So now it's time to heat up the hot end and heat up the head of the bed and start putting in some filament. So, as you can see, I have added the painter stain for now. So I'm using that for the first print, and after that I will see if I continue using that or will use something else. Now, the printer has been heated, so let's install some filament. For now I'm going to use the included PLA because they included it, so it's probably meant for this printer. So let's insert it and hope it comes out correctly. And there we go. As you might see on video, there was a small piece of black filament in there, and we are getting white now, so that's perfectly. Now let's see if we can extrude a bit from the control box. And there we go, filament is coming out, so that's perfectly working fine. So now everything seems to be in order, so time for our first print. I'm actually going to use the included model, however, I know this is a probably broken model, but they included it, so it should work. So let's see what's coming out. I'll see you in a bit. Here are the first few prints of the CR10. First, this is the screw versus nut that is printed with the CR10 default PLA. This is a model included on the SD card and came out great. You can see here the actual part of the screw and it fits perfectly. The only problem with this model that it had a raft and that was really hard to remove. So there's a bit of damage here at the top. But that's very hard to see. I didn't try to remove the raft from the other part because it's not needed to work. So if you want to try it, it screws in very nicely. The second print I made was this Banshee, and it came out great. This was sliced with Simplified 3D, used a model I found on the internet. The only problem was the first layer. You cannot see the text at all, and this was caused by the incorrect leveling of the print. That's why I tried the second Banshee, and this came out much better. Here you can see the text on the actual Banshee, if it wants to focus. There we go. The rest of the Banshee came out great as well. There's a tiny bit of stringing here, but that's all. It also is a bit low on infill at the top,
But that's probably just my multiplier that needed to be fixed a bit. In general, I'm really happy with the first outcome of this printer. So, in the coming weeks I will be printing a lot more with the CR10 and mostly large models. So, see you soon. Thanks for watching.